Did you see that? There's no driver in that delivery truck. Since October of 2022, Loblaws have been using autonomous vehicles to help make some of their deliveries in Toronto. It's the first of its kind in Canada, but we might be seeing a lot more of it in the future. So let's dig into it. This is Kayan Explains Self-Driving Cars. You probably hear a lot about driverless cars these days, but turns out people have been thinking about them and imagining them for a pretty long time. Let's start off in 1939 at the New York World's Fair.
The biggest, costliest World's Fair in all history.
The most popular exhibit at that fair was General Motors had their Futurama exhibit, where you got to see the fantastic world that we would all live in 1960. And the idea was that we would have self-driving cars by 1960. That was sort of like a dream. It was sort of a design effort. It wasn't like a real engineering project.
Fast forward to today. Autonomous technology is in most of the cars we drive today.
A number of cars have like lane departure warnings. The car can actually has sensors that can tell where it is in the lane. And if it starts to like move out of the lane slowly, it can first give a little warning. There's smart cruise controls or advanced cruise controls. What they do now is they set that at a speed, but if it senses a car coming too close, it can again give you, usually it gives you a warning, and then it will actually brake the car for you if it's approaching a car in front of you too quickly.
There is also things like rear sensors if you're backing into something, parallel parking aids, and cameras all over many cars. So that's the type of stuff that you and I could use if we were driving today. But what about that truck in Toronto, or any other autonomous vehicles? How do they drive themselves?
Without giving away our secret sauce, our autonomous trucks make use of a very extensive sensor suite. So what I'm talking about here is a number of cameras, radars, LIDARs, GNSS. All of these sensors help to ensure that the truck can perceive its surrounding environment.
In many cases, these cameras and radars and LIDARs feed into a computer that maps the surrounding environment and navigates the vehicle through it. But how do you go from assisted driving to driverless? Is it even legal? Let's take a little trip around the world to some autonomous vehicles hotspots. That Loblaws delivery truck? They're allowed because Ontario launched a pilot project in 2016 to test autonomous vehicles on public roads. And they also received special permission to go fully driverless. In Singapore, they built a fake town to allow autonomous vehicles to be tested. And surprise, surprise! Silicon Valley and San Francisco, both global tech hubs in California, have led the charge of autonomous vehicles and driverless ride-hailing services. But one of the biggest hotspots in the world is actually a hotspot in the middle of a desert. Phoenix, Arizona has been the world leader in the testing of autonomous vehicles. Why Phoenix?
The governor of Arizona announced, hey, we have no regulations here. We would love your businesses to come here. Please, he didn't say it this way, but basically what he said is, please use the citizens of my state as your guinea pigs in this experiment.
That experiment has shed some light on the problems with autonomous vehicles. In 2018, an autonomous vehicle struck and killed a woman there.
We're not quite ready yet for this technology. We don't have the technology to work that's not robust enough, which is why people are testing it, to see can we build up the understandings, robust enough computer systems to be able to make the decisions that do result in significantly safer cars. But unfortunately, we're not there yet.
So I'm actually in the process of learning how to drive and getting my driver's license. But the story has me thinking about if I actually need to. Like, maybe I should be brushing up on my power nap skills to take advantage of all the downtime in a self-driving car. Or making voice-activated commands telling my car where to take me. Like, hey car, take me to school. Now that would be a lot easier than all of these driving lessons and tests. But for the time being, I'll stick to two hands on the steering wheel and learning the basics. That's it for Kane Explains. For CBC Kids News, I'm Isabel McNeil.